piano, I love a piano. I love to hear somebody play upon a piano, a grand piano. It simply carries me away.
We want to welcome you to two pianos, four hands, and more. I'm Dale Sierra. We would like to introduce Yolette Shaw, our vocalist. Welcome to two pianos, four hands, and more. We're glad you're here.
This was Joanna Schwab, our vocalist. I'm Dale Sherrod. We have with us Scott Hamlin. Susan Sherrod Lilly. K.W. Lloyd. Karen Main. Gail Molzon. and Stephen W. Stiller. Today's concert is a benefit concert for the benefit of the Our Center and for Friends First. There are several ways to donate, and these ways are listed on the back of your program. It can be cash or check, etc. If you had a chance to donate when you came in, fine. Or as you leave, if you feel that you want to make a donation, this is fine. We'd like to remind people to silence your cell phones and to not have any flash photography. DVDs are available. You can order them out in the lobby, or you can follow the instructions, order them by email. DVDs are $15, and for each sale of a DVD, $5 will go to the Friends First, and $5 will go to the Our Center. Again, we want to say a vigorous welcome, and we hope you do enjoy the afternoon.
First piece I'm going to play is from 1911, and it was one of the very first popular jazz pieces. The bands like Jelly Roll Morton and his Red Hot Peppers used to play this piece. So here's Panama from 1911. Thank you.
on Tuesday, Byron Yost will be celebrating his 93rd birthday. Byron, would you give a hand? Go by Bud. So when we get to that part, happy birthday, dear Bud.
I'm going to play two pieces that I composed. And the first one I wrote a couple years ago when my daughter was performing at Jester's in their children's productions there. And there was one show where they kind of mixed up some of the fairy tales. And in this fairy tale, Cinderella never found Prince Charming. So she was left with one shoe. So here's the One Shoe Blues. Have you ever had a great dog? Well, we did. And after she passed, I decided to write a piece for her. So this is the Black Dog Ramble. Thank you.
And I'm supposed to transition between fiddle battle and an old and deep, deep battle. So would you just take a deep breath with me and then let it out slowly?
Thank you.
Yesterday we had a dress rehearsal here, and all of us went through all of our pieces. Gail and I did this piece yesterday called The Typewriter, and it is to signify an old-fashioned typewriter, and you hear the click, click, click of keys. Those are the piano keys. At the end of each line on the old-fashioned typewriter, well, you'd hear a bell, and that means that you'd move the carriage back and play some more. So after we did our dress rehearsal, well, the committee came up and talked to Gail and me, and they said, we want to talk to you both. And they kept talking with Gail, and they kept telling her what a good piano player she was. And they kept praising her skills and told her what a great pianist she was. I was listening to this, and then they came over to me and said, Dale, sit down, we want to talk with you. And they said, we want to tell you something, and this is for your own good. And I thought, They said, you know, Gail is a great piano player. And I said, yes, I've been hearing that for the last 3 minutes. And they said, Dale, you know, this piece, The Typewriter, it has the piano keys for the typewriter, and then at the end there's always a bell. They said, we think you would be happier and you'd have more fulfillment, Dale, if you would just do the bell part. And they said they thought it would be better if Gail, with her skill, did the piano keys. I said, well, okay. So that's what we're going to do. And they said, we're telling you this for your own good. So we're happy to present to you Leroy Anderson's piece, The Typewriter. Gail will be doing the typing part, and I'll be doing the bell. Okay, you don't have to. You don't have to. Hey, I'll tell you something. This bell thing, I find that I'm not getting much, it's not giving me much happiness and fulfillment.
If I give you a chance to play. If I give you a chance to play The Typewriter, do you think that if you tried really hard, you could keep up?
I'll try real hard.
Okay, you just get one shot.
Thank you.
brother Herbie and I were walking along the street, and we came upon one of these scales where you drop in a coin, and it gives you your weight, and a little piece of paper comes out, and the little piece of paper tells you what your future is. So my brother said, "What does it say?" I said, "Well, it says that with a lot of practice and many days of hard work, you might develop some musical talent." And my brother said, "Would you read that again?" And I did, and it said, with a lot of practice and a lot of hard work, you might develop some musical talent. And my brother said, "Dale, could I read that piece of paper?" And he did. And I hope that you enjoy this next piece. The next piece is by Jerome Kern. It's called "The Way You Look Tonight."
Thank you.
It's been a joy for all of us to perform for you today. And I just want to say a special thanks to the Hour Center and to Friends First for all the great work they do for the community. And thank you all for coming out to help support them and to hear us. But I want to give a special thanks to Dale Sherrod for all the hard work he put to put this together. Most of this is him.
Thank you so much. Our last number is The Stars and Stripes Forever. It is a patriotic number, and we are thinking of the 4th of July that is on the way. We're thinking about our country, how much it means to us, and there are, in the audience, there are some veterans. And we would like to recognize veterans and honor them, and we would like for you to stand, if you would, so we could give you a round of applause. Would the veterans please stand up and be recognized? You've been a wonderful audience, a remarkable audience. Thank you so much for coming. If you see fit to leave a donation as you leave for the Hour Center or for Friends First, that would be fine. Please enjoy with us The Stars and Stripes Forever. Thank you so much.